new photos have emerged from the southern border. These are showing exactly the current state of the migrants that have come over and come up to the border and are being detained, and the actual conditions that they're dealing with right now under the Biden administration. So we have two sets of photographs from inside the Biden administration's border detention facilities in Texas. The photographs depict hundreds of migrants, including children, confined to pods that are designed to give an appearance that the administration is concerned about the spread of the coronavirus, despite the lack of social distancing protocols, because they're all kind of just stuffed into the area. If you are watching this on video, I'm going to have pictures displayed showing that here. But James O'Keefe actually released a second batch of photographs showing everything that's going on there as well in more detail over the last few days. So there are 8 pods with 8 cells, each in the facility. At any given moment, there is an average of 3,000 people in custody there, and the illegal immigrants are separated by age or physical size depending on room. 50 were COVID positive in these cells over the last few days. There have been multiple sexual assaults, normal assaults, and daily medical emergencies. This was an issue for a while, and it's only gotten worse now because of Biden's immigration policy. The thing is that there was a guy once, I remember, I don't know if you remember, but I remember a guy that came out and basically said, look, the border crisis is pretty bad. So what we're going to do is to avoid a crisis is to build a wall so that we can make sure that we know exactly where these people are coming in at, prevent them from coming in these bad places, these spots that are dangerous, and actually go through the rightful places that they need to go through, funnel them through the right place so that we can get them checked in a orderly fashion. And we're going to try and get Mexico to help pay for the wall because they don't even like this stuff happening. Well, that basically just went out the window, didn't it? That was what Trump was wanting to do. That's what he partially completed. But the issue is that, of course, Biden, first step of action or plan of action is going to be to stop the production of the wall. And so everybody's now flooding in all of a sudden. It's not about this specific situation being different for Trump versus Biden, as much as it is the fact that the media and the Democrats aren't covering it the same way. I mean, during the Trump administration, they were literally calling these kids in cages, all of these things. They said they were literally, that it looked like a Nazi concentration camp at the southern border. Now it's under Biden and the situation is even worse. And they want to pretend like they care about COVID-19 at the same time, but they clearly are letting COVID-positive immigrants into the country. They don't care. That's what we're seeing here. It's the hypocrisy going on at the border. Jen Psaki was actually asked about this at a press conference as well.
Now that the public is seeing some of the images because the congressional delegation provided some photos and descriptions about what they witnessed, children who are frightened and crying, overcrowded conditions, now that the public has seen that, is that not a crisis? And what conditions or situation, what metrics would have to be in place for the administration to call it that?
Well, children presenting at our border who are fleeing violence, who are fleeing prosecution, who are fleeing terrible situations, is not a crisis. We feel that it is our responsibility to humanely approach this circumstance and make sure they are treated and put in conditions that are safe. I will say that these photos show what we've long been saying, which is that these Border Patrol facilities are not places made for children. They are not places that we want children to be staying for a extended period of time. Our alternative is to send children back on this treacherous journey. That is not, in our view, the right choice to make. And so our focus now is on solutions and putting in place policies, including expediting processing at the border, opening up additional facilities, something that you've seen developments on over the past several days, and there'll be certainly more on, restarting our Central American Minors Program, which was stopped in 2017. Thousands of kids should be eligible to apply for that, so they're not making this journey. So our focus is on solutions and implementing them as quickly as possible.
So she refuses to call this a crisis. If this was under Trump, absolutely, they'd be calling it that every single day. We wouldn't be able to get enough or hear enough of it. It would not matter to them. The reason why this is happening is because of Biden's failed immigration policies. And it's only going to get worse. they're letting these criminals literally, or some of them are criminals. Not all of them are criminals, obviously. We know that. But the reason why they're getting to the border is that they have the Mexican coyotes, these gangs that are dangerous, bringing over. Basically, they pay people. There's actually movies, I think it's called Sicario, that shows a lot of how this process works. But they basically pay these immigrants money to bring them over. These cartels and these other gangs and things, to bring them to the border in a sort of safe passage, but they don't really take good care of them at all. So oftentimes you wind up with kids, not with their actual parents, that are with other adults that are just bringing the kids so they can use the kids as a means to get in. I mean, it's a really mixed up situation. It never was easy. It never is a straightforward thing. There's nobody saying that Trump's immigration policy was perfect. That doesn't make any sense. He was trying to make it better and improve upon what was already there. But the issue is that going back to the way that it was, you wind up with all of these people basically flooding through the border. And then they basically detain them. And they say, okay, come back in 3 months. Here's your court date where we're going to go through all of the things that needs to basically happen to deport you or whatever if we need to do that. Well, guess what? They're not going to show up for that. None of them do. Very few of them do. And you wind up with this problem with people just basically coming into the United States, no court date, or with a court date, and they don't come to the court date, and nobody knows where they're at that point in time, and they just do whatever they want to do. That was always the problem. To make it seem as if it was some easy solution is ridiculous. But at the same time, going back on everything Trump was doing that improved the situation is going to make it look even worse. And they're going to do everything in their power not to call it a crisis, even though you know that they would call it that, regardless of what's happening. You just watched a clip from the William Hall Show. Please remember to like, share, and subscribe.